这一堂题目是活出生命之道第二集，敬拜主来做互相勉励。
So the topic for mutual encouragement is the living word of life, the second part, which is worship the Lord.
我们有一些人在第一堂没有听到。
And some might not have heard the first session.
我们提到这个十诫呢，其实是生命之道。
And we mentioned that the Ten Commandments are actually the words of life.
只是我们通常能误解了这个十诫。
But most of us have mistaken the meaning of the Ten Commandments.
这十诫是一个很基础，告诉以色列人什么叫对，什么是错的。
So the Ten Commandments told the Israelites what are right and wrong.
可是我们看圣经的时候，要看出它的精义，神要的是什么。
But when we read the Bible, we have to understand the essence and the spirit of the words.
我们提到神要我们尽心、尽性、尽意、尽力爱神。
And we have mentioned that we have to love our Lord with all your heart, all your mind, and all your strength.
那我们来看第二条诫命。
And now let's look at the second commandment.
出埃及记二十章。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 20.
出埃及记二十章的第四节到第六节。
Exodus chapter 20, verse 4 to 6.
二十章的第四节。
Chapter 20, verse 4.
不可为自己雕刻偶像，也不可做什么形象，仿佛上天、下地和地底下、水中的百物。第五节。
Five.
不可跪拜那些像，也不可侍奉他，因为我神你的神是祭邪的神，恨我的，我必追讨他的罪，自父及子，直到三四代。我们看第六节。
Six.
爱我、守我诫命的，我必向他们发慈爱，直到千代。在这个第四节里面呢，我们第四节、第五节，我们看到有三个主要的动词。
So in verse 4 to 5, it has three important verbs.
第一个就是不要为自己雕刻偶像。
So the first one, you shall not make yourself a carved image.
第二个动词在第五节就是不可不跪拜。
And the second verse is shall not bow down.
第三就是不可侍奉。
And not to serve.
那这些事呢，我们通常就想说，我不去做这些事，我就是好基督徒。
And most of the time, we think that as long as we don't do these things, then we are considered as good Christians.
那我们想想看，我们跟植物人有好在哪里？
So how are we better than the vegetated person?
植物人也不会做这些事啊。
Because a vegetated person will not do these things.
那神绝对要求我们做更多啊。
But God wanted us to do even more.
我们可以摸着良心说，我真的有尽心尽性尽神尽意爱神，因为我没有去拜偶像。
And can we ask ourselves that we do worship God with all our heart, all our might, and all our strength because we don't worship idols?
其实我们可以做的更多啊，不只是就说就是没有拜偶像就足够了。其实我们可以做的更多。
But we can do even more because just not worshiping idols is not good enough.
那这第二条诫命，神到底要的是什么？
So what did God want from us from this second commandment?
我们看第四节。
Let's read verse 4.
其实就是把这个不可做什么，反过来要做什么。
So we should look at, instead of saying, do not do these things, but instead, what shall we do?
其实我们要做的是要有耶稣基督的形象啊。
So it means that what we have to have is the image of Lord Jesus Christ.
在新约里面，保罗书信圣经上有讲很多很多很多，只是我们读的时候没有发觉到神要我们有耶稣基督的形象。
And in the New Testament, and especially in the Paul's letters, it kept saying that there are many things we should do, which is the image of Christ.
我们来看几个经节。
Let's read a few verses.
我们看哥罗西书第三章。
Let's go to Galatians chapter 3.
第十节。
Chapter 3, verse 10.
哥罗西书第三章第十节。
Galatians chapter 3, verse 10.
哥罗西书第三章第十节。
Galatians chapter 3, verse 10.
穿上了新人，这新人在知识上渐渐更新，正如照他主的形象。在这里，保罗鼓励哥罗西的教会信徒呢，要穿上新人。
So here, Paul encouraged the members there to put on a new self, a new man.
这个新人呢，是有主的形象啊。
And this new man carried the image of Christ.
我们再看以弗所书第四章。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 4.
第四章二十三节。
Chapter 4, verse 23.
二十四节。二十三节。以弗所书第四章。
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 23.
又要将你们的心智更换一新，24节。
24.
并且穿上新人，这新人是照着神的形象造的，有真理的仁义和圣洁。保罗又跟另外一个教会叫以弗所教会讲同样的事情。
And now Paul said to the similar thing to the different church, Ephesians.
要穿上这个新人啊。
And to be put on a new man.
这个新人就是有神的形象。
And this new man has the image of Christ.
但你会讲说这个形象很抽象。
It seems like this image is rather abstract.
可是他告诉我们说有真理的仁义和圣洁。
But this image has the true righteousness and holiness.
就是看到我们主耶稣所作所为所说的所想的，是公义的，是慈爱的，是分别为圣的。
So it means that everything that Lord Jesus did or everything that had in his mind is righteous, holy, and pure.
我们再看罗马书第八章。
Let's also turn to Romans chapter 8.
罗马书第八章。
Romans chapter 8.
29节。
Verse 29.
在这里保罗跟罗马教会信徒这样说。
And here, Paul said to the members in Romans church.
我们可以看到说保罗到什么教会都跟人讲说要像耶稣基督了。
So basically, wherever Paul went, he always tell the members to have the image of Lord Jesus Christ.
在这里说，因为他预先所知道的人，就预先定下效法他儿子的模样，使他儿子在许多弟兄中做长子。请念。
Verse 29, for whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren.
其实神在创造天地之前呢，他已经定好了他要做什么事。
So before God created everything, he already predestined what to do.
他已经选，世界还没有创造之前，神已经选召有一些人呢，要成为他的百姓。
Before he created this heaven earth, that he already decided which people he will be choosing.
那这些百姓呢，神有目的给他们。
And while he chose these people, he has a reason and goal for them.
要这一些百姓呢，要有耶稣基督的形象啊。
And this is to have these people to have the image of Christ.
这个是神在创造人类之前已经想好的目标给人类。
And this is something that God had already decided and predestined before he created man.
这是何等的重要啊。
Think about how important this is.
在我们还没有出生，任何人还没有显现之前，神已经想好这是最好的给人类。
Before we were even born, and God has already given this to us, and this is the best for humankind.
哥林多前书十一章。哥林多前书十一章。
Let's turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
第一节。
First one.
哥林多前书十一章第一节，这是保罗跟哥林多教会所说的话。
And in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 1, and this is what God said to the people in Corinth.
保罗跟哥林多教会所说的话。
And this is the things that Paul said to the people in Corinth.
第一节说，你们该效法我，像我效法基督一样。
In verse 1, imitate me just as I also imitate Christ.
保罗呢，这个哥林多教会是像婴孩的教会啊。
Because people in Corinth just like infant.
很属世啊，很属肉体。
Because they were very secular.
所以保罗就用他的这个本身呢，来让他们了解。
So Paul used himself so they could understand.
就说怎么效法耶稣基督，就效法他的榜样，效法保罗的榜样。
So how to imitate Christ, which is to imitate Paul first.
这个保罗做很好的榜样，让他们来学习，让他们可以认识耶稣是谁，而且这是来效法跟耶稣一样。
Because Paul set a good example of how Christ is, so if they look at Paul, they know how Christ should behave.
其实还有在其他的书信，保罗也告诉门徒说要像耶稣一样，只是不同的说法，可是意思都一样的。
So in a lot of other letters, Paul also said to imitate him, but in different ways and in verses.
那请问，我们听道理听这么多了，有没有这个心啊，要有耶稣基督的形象？
So since we have believed in Christ for so long, do we have the heart to be like Jesus, to have the image of Jesus.
我们有没有真的在追求要跟耶稣一样？
Have you pursued to be like Jesus?
有时候听一些信徒说了。
And sometimes I heard members saying,
我希望我的孩子像个最有钱的人一样。
I wish my children to be like the richest person in the world.
世界上最有钱是谁？
So who is the richest person in the world right now?
现在是那个 Elon Musk.
Right now it's Elon Musk.
那有些人说啊，我很希望我的孩子啊，就像某某人电视上这么有智慧，这么会说话。
And I wish that my children could be like certain celebrities who is so wise and able to talk and be eloquent.
还是像某某教授，知道很多知识。
Or to be a certain professor who has so much knowledge.
那我们如果这样说的话，其实我们的无形中呢，我们所拜的是，该说应该说偶像，我们所拜的偶像就显明出来了。
So unknowingly, when we say that, we our idols in our heart have shown.
而且我们想把我们的偶像呢介绍给我们孩子，让我们孩子也有这种形象。
And even more, we want to bring this type of idols before our children so that our children will bear that image.
有时候真的，我没有很少听到说啊，我希望我孩子像耶稣基督啊。孩子，你的目标不是啊，拿好成绩赚大钱啊。我要你的是什么？要有耶稣基督的形象。
And very rarely I hear parents saying that, oh, my child, I want you to be like Jesus. And instead saying, I want you to have good grades and good academics.
这是值得我们来思考。
And this is something that we should really ponder upon.
我们可以借着人所作所为所说的，就看到说这个人到底在拜什么东西。
So from what people say and how they behave, we can see what kind of image or idols they worship.
我记得我在国小的时候。
I remember when I was in elementary school.
我有些同学。
Some of my classmates.
我一看这个同学，我就知道说他在拜什么。
When I look at my classmates, I knew immediately what kind of idols they worship.
我一看这个人就想，就让我想起这是像某某人。
Because when I look at him, I really it kind of remind me of certain person.
比如说了，我在国小的时候五年级啊，有一些黑人弟兄啊，不是黑人同学。
So when I was in grade five, I had some African classmates.
那我一看到他呢，我就说，哎，这个像 Michael Jackson.
When I saw him, and I thought, he looks like Michael Jackson.
为什么？
Why is it so?
不管是男的女的哦，都穿这种那个皮衣，那个皮衣里面呢，皮衣有很多那种金属啊，一点一点一点的。So
because when I look at him, regardless if they're a boy or girls, they wear this black leather jacket with studs.
那头发跟这个 Michael Jackson 很一样。And
the hairstyle looks like just like Michael Jackson.
现在年轻人可能不知道 Michael Jackson 是谁吧。So
maybe nowadays the youngster don't know who Michael Jackson is.
可是，在那时候呢，他们也常常唱这个 Michael Jackson 的歌。
And very often at that time, my classmates sang songs from Michael Jackson.
还跳那种舞，叫做 moonwalking， 就是说，好像你在走前进，可是你在退后。
And they even do the moon dance, moonwalking dance.
所以你看到这种人，你就知道说他在拜的是什么。
So when you look at them, you immediately know that what kind of idols they worship.
他的穿着，他的长。 打扮，他的想法，他说的话，他唱的歌，都是像他一样的。The
way they speak, the way they dress, and the way they behave, they're just like that idol.
那叫做崇拜啊。And
that's idol worshiping.
今天呢，可能有人不知道 Michael Jackson 是谁，可是应该很多人知道 Swift Taylor 是谁吧。And
now we might not know who Michael Jackson is, but we know who Taylor Swift is. Yes.
应该知道哈，那不知道没关系，我跟你讲一下。If
you don't know, don't worry, I will introduce her to you.
这个一个女歌星呢，她唱歌哦，这个大家买票都买不到啊。And
this
很多人买不到票。
This female singer, like when she had concert, most people can't even buy tickets.
有次看到一个小姐妹。And
once I saw a little sister.
差不多十几岁吧。Maybe
a teenager.
那我就。 看他在唱歌。And
she was singing.
那我问他，他唱什么歌
？So I'm asking her, what kind of songs are you singing?
他说他唱那个 Swift Taylor 的歌。And
she was singing songs from Taylor Swift.
他还把那个歌啊，给我看。And
she even showed me her video.
No, not video. 的歌就是那个 lyric.
Just the lyrics.
The words 就是那些字了。 Okay.
She showed me her lyrics.
我看那些字以后，我差点昏倒。
And when I saw those lyrics, I almost fainted.
好多字啊！
And there were a lot of words.
像一篇文章一样啊。
It's almost like an essay.
不是 essay， paragraph 啊。
Oh, just a paragraph。
很，可是蛮长的、哦。
But it was a long paragraph。
我很佩服啊，这个姐妹可以把全部的歌曲背起来。
And was so impressed that she could even memorize all the lyrics。
我想说，她会不花点时间把那个赞美诗还是圣经的圣经的话都背起来
？And I was wondering why wouldn't she just spend the time to memorize Bible verses or the hymns？
啊，后来我才知道说 ，Sweet 这个 Sweet Taylor 长怎么样，发觉到那个姐妹也长怎么样。
So、
她的头发型也是一样。
So when I look at a picture of Taylor Swift, and I realized that sister looked just like her.
穿着也差不多一样。
And even the way she dressed looked like her.
这个大家都有这种经历了，年轻的时候都有一种偶像啊，这个人太美了啦，我要跟她一样。
And when we were young, I'm sure you all have gone through this because we look at these celebrities, they're so beautiful, we want to be like them.
可是长大以后呢，还是有这种。我们有自己想要的形象。
And but when you grow up, you still have kind of this image that you want to be.
可是这个通常这种我们想要的形象跟主耶稣没有关系的。
But this image that we pursue after usually has nothing to do with Lord Jesus Christ.
所以我们可以想说，圣经上其实神要的是要我们有耶稣基督的形象。我们真的有没有去追求耶稣基督的形象吗？
But in the Bible, it clearly says that God wants us to have the image of Christ. But do we ever pursue this kind of image?
那如果没有的话，其实我们没有在真的行第二诫，守第二条诫命。
If we do not have this pursuit, then means that we don't keep the second commandment.
那我们翻回来这个出埃及记二十章。
Let's turn back to Exodus chapter 20.
第五节。
Chapter 20, verse 5.
在这里告诉我们不可跪拜那些像。
Here it says that we cannot bow down to these idols.
我们要怎么样？才有基督的形象的。
So how do we have this image of Lord Jesus?
其实就是把这经节反过来。
Which is to flip this message around.
就是说我们要敬拜耶稣基督啊。
It means that we have to worship and bow down to Lord Jesus.
敬拜耶稣基督就有基督耶稣基督的形象。
Once we bow down and worship Christ, then we have His image.
那什么叫做敬拜
？What does it mean to worship?
什么叫跪拜？跪拜。
So what does it mean to bow down?
好，我去查这个字啊。这个 worship， 因为在英文是叫 worship， 我就查这个 worship 这个字。
So I trying to look up the word worship。
那这个 worship， 我看到字典，首先它是不只是就说跪拜，就是不只是跪下来，而是一种崇拜 ，adore， 一种你很想要跟这个人跟这个一样。
So when I look up this word worship, not only you have to bow down, but you also have to adore this person to want to be, long to be with this person.
那如果我们没有这个心的话，我们很难说我们会去追求有耶稣基督的形象。
And if we don't have this mentality, then we can't have the pursuit of Lord Jesus.
那不只是要有这个心呢，还要有正确的方法。
Not only we should have this heart and mentality, but we have to have the correct method.
所以我们在敬拜上才会有像耶稣基督一样。
So that when we worship God, we will have this image of Christ.
我们来看约翰福音第四章的二十三节。
Let's turn to John chapter 4, verse 23.
约翰福音第四章的二十三节。
John chapter 4, verse 23.
约翰福音第四章二十三节这里说：“时候将到，如今就是了。那真正拜父的，要用心灵。”
Verse 23, but the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father is seeking such a worship to him.
所以这个经节一方面告诉我们，其实在今天世界上有很多人在拜神，可是都用很多的方法，其他方法，而不是按真理，也不是按心灵在拜神。
So today there are many people who worship God, but they use their own methods. They did not use the method of worship in spirit and truth.
好，那要这样子拜神，用心灵和真理拜神，才可能有耶稣基督的形象。
And only if you worship God in this manner, then you have the image of Christ.
好，所以今天有很多人来聚会，可是不一定有耶稣基督的形象，因为他没有按照这个心灵和真理在拜神。
And today when we worship God, we don't always worship God in this way because they don't use the spirit and truth.
好，比如说了，我们参加聚会，对不对？是不是在拜神
？And for example, when you come attend services, do you truly worship God?
看看我们有按照神的方法去做。
It's the matter of whether you worship in the image of God.
因为有些人来到教会，肉体在这里，心不在这里。
And sometimes you worship God, your body is here, but your spirit is not here.
所以听道理就是右耳进去，左耳出去，就你再怎么听一百次，也不会像耶稣基督一样。
Because when you listen, you just come from your right ear and come out on your left ear.
所以听道理呢，不只是肉体要在啊，心呢、啊。要在。
So when you listen to the sermon, you also have not only your body is here, but your heart is has to be.
所以用心就是用心，就是要 concentrate， 就是要用专心的、
啊。And when your heart means you have to focus and concentrate.、
而且呢，神也要我们什么，敬意爱神，用意就是用头脑，就去用思考，听道理的时候要去思考。
And God said you have to use your mind to worship.、
就是听道理的时候要去思考。
So it means that when you listen to the sermon, you have to think.
好，那用真理就是按照神的方法。
And using truth means using God's method.
不是用我们自己的方法。
And not using your own method.
就像我们这次布道会啊，我们都有看到神告诉我们要怎么做，才得到神的应许，而不是说自己去想象一些方法跟圣经上无关的，就是自己想些方法来得到神的应许。
It means that when you come to get God's promises, you have to use God's method.
那看圣经的时候要看上下文，要了解它的含义，而不是自己去创造。
And when you listen to read the Bible, you have to understand the meaning and from the entire phrase of the Bible.
所以我们常常用已经解经了，已经解经。
So you have to interpret the verses with another verses.
好，那么同样的读圣经呢、啊？也是也要用这样的方法读圣经，才会真的学到耶稣基督的形象。
So in the same time, when you read the Bible, you have to read the Bible in the same way, so that you can understand the image.
比如说，第一，读圣经的时候要眼睛看嘛。
For example, when you read the Bible, you have to use your eyes.
那我们要花时间了、啊，要抽时间出来，你才有机会去看圣经。
And you have to spend time.To read the Bible.
好，那第二，看圣经的时候要用头脑去看、去想。
And secondly, when you read the Bible, you have to use your mind to think.
因为有时候我们没有用头脑去想，我们就只是看到字面上的意思。
And without using your mind to think, you only see what's on the surface.
好，我们没办法去真的了解神要的是什么，神要跟我们讲的是什么。
You weren't able to understand what God really wants you to do.
其实神在旧约里面，圣经把旧约的这个历史故事都当成用比喻来跟我们讲。
And God used the story in the Old Testament as parables, as stories to tell us.
那既然是比喻，那这个就是一种智慧人的言语啊，这要去思考，你才真的会去了解里面在讲什么。
And since these are parables, you have to think the deeper meaning.
所以有些人连那个故事本身到底在教导什么都不问，这个更不用提说，真的圣经上在讲什么道理，我们没办法去了解。
And sometimes you don't even think about the moral of the story, then how can you understand the teachings?
好，那在读圣经的时候呢，还要用这个心啊去读。
And when you read the Bible, you have to read it with your heart.
什么叫用心去读？
What does it mean by read with your heart?
不只是专心，而是要把那个有也要有感情呐、啊。心都是代表爱啊，感情。
It means that you don't just read it, but you have to read it with emotions.
好，那这个是我们很多人觉得很抽象，这什么意思
？And many of us feel this is very abstract. What does it mean?
我就讲个故事好了。
And let me tell you a story.
来形容什么用心去读。
And to describe what does it mean to read with your heart?
在古代台湾呢，在还没有电话的时候
，In the olden times when there was no telephone，
还是电话不是那么普遍的时候了
，Or maybe it wasn't common。
那有一户家庭，爸爸妈妈是做农夫的，不识字。
And there was this family, and they don't know words, they're illiterate。
他不识字，They're not educated.
They were not educated.
那么，大女儿呢，去台北读大学，后来在台北打工。
So the elder daughter, she went to Taipei to work.
那小女儿还在国中。
But she was the youngest daughter was still in middle school.
那每个礼拜呢，这个大女儿会写信呢，给她爸爸妈妈。
And every week, the eldest daughter will write a letter to the parents.
当信来了，这个爸爸妈妈会叫小女儿呢来读这个信给他们听。
And when the letter came, the eldest daughter will ask the younger daughter to read the letter to them.
那每次这个小女儿读完以后呢，她看到她父母亲呢，眼睛呢都会有眼泪。
And after the youngest daughter read the letter, she saw tears in her father's eyes.
她就觉得自己很奇怪，我读了我没有感受，为什么我的父母有这么多感受？
And then she felt that when she read the letter, I feel okay. Why does my why were my parents moved?
因为她读的时候，她用眼睛啊在看。
Because when I was reading, she just read it with her eyes.
可是她父母亲在听的时候是用心去听。
But when her parents listened to the letter, they used their heart to listen.
这个父母亲听到女儿受到的困难种种一切，仿佛就像他自己受到这些困难一样。
And when he heard all the difficulties and trials that the daughter gone through, he felt like it was his own tribulations and trials.
那同样。 我们读圣经的时候，要用这种态度去看圣经。
And when we read the Bible, we should use the same mentality to read the Bible.
如果我们去看的话，你会觉得说这个圣经很活啊，好像是真的，你可以感受到那里面的爱啊，那里的情况。
And when you read in such manner, the words becomes alive, and you could feel the words.
比如说好了，在创世纪44章、45章那边记载着这个。 约瑟呢，要强留，用不择手段要把这个便雅悯留在他身边呢。
For example, in Genesis chapter 44 to 45, Joseph forced Benjamin to stay near him.
那这时候犹大呢，就说了一些话，告诉这个约瑟说，不行了，这个便雅悯要回去他父亲那边，否则父亲会死。
But Joseph, Judah said to Joseph that no, we cannot keep Benjamin here because if Benjamin stayed behind, his father will be heartbroken.
那后来呢，这个约瑟就大哭啊。
And then Joseph just wept bitterly.
那我不知道大家读了那故事，你会不会哭啊？跟约瑟一起哭。
When you read the story, do you weep with Joseph?
如果你会跟约瑟一起哭，那你就已经会用心去读圣经了。
If you weep with Joseph, it means that you read the Bible with your heart.
如果你读了圣经，觉得说这约瑟为什么会哭，我还不知道啊，那你根本还不知道怎么用心去读。
But if you read these verses and you're wondering why did Joseph cry, then it means that you don't read it with your heart.
真的，大家回去试试看啊，你用心去读，你真的会觉得说这个圣经啊，哇，这么美，这个犹大，他的内在真的是很有爱心啊。
And if you read it with your heart, you realize that Joseph has so much in his love, in his mind, in his heart.
他的话感动了约瑟，也可以感动了我们。
Because his words moved Joseph, it could also move us.
所以圣经有很多地方真的是你用心去读，你就会体会到很多东西是我没有时间跟大家讲全部了。
And if you read the Bible with your heart, then you realize that a lot of things can move you, and I can't tell you all.
还有一点就是读圣经的时候要用有圣灵的启示。
And secondly, when you read the Bible, you have to read it with the inspiration of the Holy Spirit.
因为有些东西呢是言语写字写不出来的。
Because a lot of things, it cannot be written by words.
而是要圣灵启示给我们。
Rather, it has to be inspired by the Holy Spirit.
比如说，圣经上说神是爱。
For example, the Bible says God is love.
那世界上有很多的爱，爱有很多不同的层次。
And there are many levels of love that is described in the Bible.
那我记得有一次在祷告里面。
And I remember once I was praying.
被圣灵充满，神让我知道什么叫做神是爱。
And I was filled by the Holy Spirit, and God allowed me to know what does it mean by love, God is love.
老实讲，我也说不出来。 And 我没办法跟你讲，因为那种是一种感受，一种启示，你知道了。可是这个是字言语没办法形容的。
And honestly, I can't even explain to you how I felt because this is an experience that I had.
那我知道说，哦，原来神是这样子，那我也要这样子做。
And it tells me that God is like this, and I have to be like him.
那还有一次，在这个大家都每次联恩会有洗礼的话，都会讲到这个洗脚礼啊。
And every time in spiritual convocation, we talk about foot washing.
我发觉到洗脚礼，这个洗脚礼，这个也是要圣灵启示啊。
And we also realize that the foot washing has to be inspired by the Holy Spirit.
因为有些东西呢是字没办法字句看不出来的。
And a lot of times that words cannot describe.
比如说，神那有一次看到一个异象。
For example, once I saw a vision.
看到主耶稣在洗门徒的脚。
And once I saw that Lord Jesus was washing the disciples' feet.
我记得那个背景是一个很大的房间。
And I remember it was in a huge room.
可能就像这么大，可是没有这么高。
It's just like this room, but not as high.
那么这个是在晚上，所以有一些灯光，可是不是很亮。
It was at night time, so there was some light, but which wasn't very bright.
我看到主耶稣拿着这个水盆在洗门徒的脚。
And I saw Lord Jesus held a basin and started washing disciples' feet.
那神让我看到主耶稣在洗门徒的脚的那种心态、动机。
And Lord allowed me to see the intention and the way that Lord Jesus washed the feet.
我看的时候，我只流着眼泪。
When I saw that, I started tearing up.
很美啊。
It was so beautiful.
美到我都会哭。
It was so beautiful to the point that I cried.
你有没有看过那种美到你会想要哭吗？
Have you ever seen something that's so beautiful that made you cry?
美到我自己跟我自己说，我要跟耶稣一样。
And to the point that I told myself, I want to be like Jesus.
所以有些事情，看圣经真的是要有圣灵启示。
So when you see certain things, it has to be through the Holy Spirit.
那我们这样子看，才真的可以看到耶稣基督，也可以敬拜他，有耶稣基督的形象。
And when we look at this, then we will see Lord Jesus and see His image and to worship Him with His image.
我们讲到敬拜，不只是参加聚会、读圣经，也包括了什么唱赞美诗啊。
So when we talk about worship, not just reading Bible or attending services, but also including singing hymns.
可是我们要做的正确，才到敬拜，借着唱诗在敬拜神。
But we have to do it in the right way, so that we can also worship God through hymns.
那我们才有耶稣基督的形象。
Then we can carry the image of God.
比如说，在唱诗的时候，要口唱心和，就不止嘴巴在唱，心里也要唱。
For example, when you sing hymns, you just don't sing words or lyrics, but you have to sing it with your heart.
所以，其实我们大家在敬拜神这个功夫上要怎么做，还要加强。如果我们做得正确，很自然的，我们会无形中就是在敬拜神上面越像基督了。
So when we worship God, we have to worship in the right way. So unknowingly, then we will be like Jesus.
好，那我们看这个第三个。
Let's read the third point.
怎么？有耶稣基督的形象。
How do you have the image of Christ?
我们来看这个出埃及记。
Let's turn to Exodus.
二十章。
Exodus chapter 20.
第五节。
Chapter 20 verse 5.
下一句动词呢，就是也不可侍奉他。
And the next verb is not to serve them.
我们不能侍奉偶像，可是我们反过来，我们要侍奉神啊。
So we cannot serve idols. So how do we serve God?
不是，我们要侍奉神。
So yeah. So how do we have to serve God?
那如果说我们是不拜偶像，这可以吗？可是神要的什么？我们要侍奉神，不是侍奉偶像。
So is it okay to worship idol? No. But what should we do? We shall serve God.
那其实神也要借着侍奉，借着我们来侍奉神，让我们跟耶稣基督一样。
So God wants us to serve Him so that we can be like Jesus.
比如说，有些父母亲呢告诉孩子，就说：“孩子啊，这个你洗碗筷呢，我就给你一些钱。”
For example, some parent told the children, "If you wash the dishes, then I'll give you some money."
那有些父母亲呢很有智慧。
And some parents have great wisdom.
他要的不是给孩子钱。
What they want is not just to give the children money.
而是要孩子借着洗碗筷去让他体会到说我们是家里的一份子，我们要彼此相爱，我们要帮助父母。
Rather, they want the children to know, to realize that they are part of this children, part of this family while they serve this family.
就像神其实是这样子, 神, 告诉我们有奖赏, 不是他有奖赏。
And for example, God said there are rewards.
当然要按神的方法去服侍神才有奖赏, 不是说, 像牛氓啊, my way or highway, 就说你不是按照我的方法, 你就给我滚蛋, 这种服侍神的方法就 不是那么好啊，这个从神那边不会得到赏赐的。
But you have to get rewarded only if you worship God in His ways. If you do any ways or your way, you will not get the reward.
我们要了解，我们就在服事神上面，我们在学习神的方法嘛。So
when
我们在学习神的方法，那我们在服事神上面也是一种敬拜。
So when we serve God, we're learning His ways, and that's how we can also be like Him.
像他一样，而且也是一种敬拜，敬拜神。
So just like Him, so that it's a way to worship Him.
所以这个敬拜用真理敬拜神啊，这不只是限制于在说来听道理、读圣经，而是也是一种把我们所学习的道理行出来。那这个行出来是一种敬拜。
So to worship Him in the truth, not just coming to church, but also to worship Him in our understanding truth.
那我们刚刚讲到，神用奖赏一方面是鼓励我们来学习神的道，来服侍神。
So God uses rewards for us so that we can use this to worship Him.
更重要的是，借着服侍神当中呢，我们学习到神的道，可以活出耶稣基督的形象。And
more importantly, while we serve Him, we can live the image of Christ.
那我们最后看一个经节。
Let's read a verse.
马太福音第四章。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 4.
第四章。
Matthew chapter 4.
第八节到第十节。
First 8 to 10.
马太福音第四章第八节。
Matthew chapter 4, verse 8 to 10.
魔鬼又带他上了一座最高的山, 将世上的万国与万国的荣华都指给他看, 第九节。
9.
对他说, 你若俯伏拜我, 我就把这一切都赐给你, 第十节。
10.
耶稣说, 撒旦, 退去吧, 因为经上记着说, 当拜主你的神, 单要侍奉他。 在这里是主耶稣引用刚才我们所读到的这个第二条诫命, 来胜过魔鬼。
So here is the verse that Lord Jesus used, what we read, the second commandments, and to overcome Satan.
我们要想想看，这个魔鬼是用多么大的这种引诱啊，在引诱耶稣。
And you can have to understand that this Satan used a great temptation to tempt Lord Jesus.
他告诉耶稣说：“我，你看这个全世界的荣华富贵、财产啊，我都可以给你。”
And he showed him that all these glories on the world I can give it to you.
只要你弯一个腰，我就全部都给你了。
As long as you bow down to me, and all these will be given to you.
请问我们做不做？
So let's ask ourselves, do we do this?
我猜想我们很多人会做。
Maybe we would.
为什么？ 因为我们魔鬼不需要把这个什么世界的荣华富贵给我们看， 只要有时候给我们一两万块钱，我们都做了。
Because Satan doesn't have to show us the glory of the world as long as they show us maybe $1,000,000.
一两万块。
Or $10,000 or $20,000.
有句话说了, 每一个人都有个价钱啊, 你要我做什么事对不对? 出好的价钱, 我可以接受的价钱我就做。
And most people say that each of us have a price tag. If you give me this price tag, I will do whatever you want.
对不对? 你要打工嘛, 工作对不对? 薪水不够你不想做, 薪水够的话, 好, 我就帮你做。
For example, when you look for a job, if the salary is only a certain amount, no, I won't do it. But if it's more, then yes, I will do it.
我们有时候会笑这个犹大说为了三十两银子把耶稣给卖掉。
And most of the time, we laugh at Judas because he sold Jesus with 30 denarii.
你知道吗? 有时候我把耶稣给卖了，连三十块银子都不到啊，还输给这个犹大。
So if you want to sell Jesus, we can't even beat Judas because he sold
有一些人为了一些金钱、有些好处，对不对？就出卖自己的信仰、出卖自己的原则、圣经上的话语、神的话语，违背神的话语去做了。
Sometimes we just want to, for certain benefits for ourselves, we will go against our morals and our belief.
可是主耶稣真的去看到这个神的命令， 的宝贵，还有他的生命。
The Lord Jesus realized the life and the importance of the Ten Commandments.
敬拜神是多么好的一件事。
It is such an important thing to worship God.
因为借敬拜神，我们有耶神的形象。
Because if we worship God, we carry the image of Christ.
这个形象是多么的荣耀，多么的尊贵。
And this image is such so precious and glorious.
而且借着侍奉神，我们得到赏赐，我们有帮助我们得到这种神的形象，是多么有价值，胜过世上的财宝啊！
And when we have this, this we will be exceeding more than all the treasures of the world.
所以主耶稣看到这一切，所以他觉得说，这个荣华富贵跟神的要给我的比起来，差得太远了啦。
So Lord Jesus realized that everything that God has is more than anything on the world.
从真的侍奉神上面，不只是得到赏赐，还得到心中的满足喜乐。
When you worship God, not only you receive reward, but also receive content in your heart.
好，所以希望我们大家可以看到这第二条诫命的重要性。
So I hope that all of you can see the importance of the second commandment.
而不是用负动、被动的看法去看，而用主动的看法去看。
But we don't look at it passively, rather you look at it actively.
如果我们看到了，我们去追求。来敬拜神，有耶稣基督的形象，那真的这个世界上的什么魔鬼的试，用世界上来试探我们，我会觉得说那是垃圾呀。
And when we worship God with all these mentalities, and we treat everything on the world as garbage.
否则我们会像犹大，为了一些好处，把信仰给卖掉了。
Otherwise, we'll be like Judas for certain own benefits and sell Jesus.
好，所以我们今天讲了这个三个重点。
So today we talk about three points.
第一个重点。
First.
就是要有耶稣基督的形象。
First is to have the image of Christ.
第二个就是敬拜神。
Second is to worship God.
我们讲到怎么来敬拜神，用真理和心灵来敬拜神。
And we talk about how do we worship God? We have to worship God with truth.
不管是在听道上面、读圣经上面、唱诗上面，还没有讲到祷告了。祷告常常祷告会都讲怎么祷告神才有用。
So no matter if it's reading Bible or worshiping in the chapel or singing hymns, but we didn't talk about prayer, but we also have worship God.
好，那最后就是我们也借着侍奉神来帮助我们达到有耶稣基督的形象。
And lastly, we have to through provide service to God, we can have the image of Christ.
好，我们一同来唱赞美诗。
Let's sing hymn of praise.
232首。
232.